Hi everybody, Joey here again, and welcome back. So today's video is actually inspired by the Eheim 2262, easily one of my favorite canister filters. It's huge, pushes a ton of water, and its simple design makes it easy to care for. But at $500, it quickly loses its appeal to many people. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to build the main component to a monster-sized canister filter of equal size for under $25. So let's jump right into it. You're going to need a bucket, and chances are you already have one. But if not, Walmart sells 5-gallon buckets for about $3. That'll work for this project. I'm personally using a 6-gallon bucket in this example. You'll also need a gamma seal lid, and this is what makes this project. The way this works is simple. There's an outer ring that snaps onto the bucket and forms a waterproof seal due to the gasket in it. Then the top screws into the ring, and this also forms a waterproof seal due to its gasket. Now we have a truly waterproofed bucket with a removable lid. I do find that after you snap the ring on, it won't come off. It will basically be permanent. I also found that lubricating the screw-on lid's gasket also helps to create a watertight seal. Now I tested a few of these lids prior to moving forward with this project, and I did find that the only downside is that you really have to tighten this lid down really tight so it not to leak under pressure. With that said, if white is not your favorite color for this canister, they do come in a variety of colors. Personally, I like the blue or the black. Now these lids are actually surprisingly easy to find as well. While I got mine on Amazon for about $11, they are also sold on places like Lowe's and Costco. And while they're not difficult to find, they certainly are a specialty item, so you will have to do some looking around. But at this point, I've invested $15. Now to turn it into a filter. Remember the time we used those Uniseals to do projects like the inline heater? Well, we're going to use them again. If you don't remember, these are just like bulkheads, but have many more places that they can actually be installed, and are easier to install, in fact. For example, the side of a curved bucket. Now, I used a pair of 1-inch Uniseals for this project, and I drill a hole in the bottom and the side of the lid and install those Uniseals. Now I can pass PVC pipe into the bucket and form a watertight seal around it. Now, having a hole in the bottom and the top means that one can be the entrance and one can be the exit. Now, onto the inside. All we need to do here is build a platform to hold your biological media above the Uniseal so we don't clog it. So I simply cut some PVC pipe slightly taller than the entrance of the Uniseal and built a stand with lighting diffuser. Now you can silicone the PVC pipes in place if you like, but once you place the media on top, they'll stay put. Now water can be pumped into the top through some mechanical media and like some filter floss, and then down through your biological media like lava rock, for example, and then out through the bottom and back up to the tank. Or simply reverse it all and pump water in through the bottom and out through the top. Cleaning it is as simple as shutting your pump off, twisting the cap off, removing your mechanical media or replacing it, and putting the cap back on, turning the pump back on. So obviously we're missing the return and input as well as the pump. But to be honest, I simply didn't have enough time to get it done this week as I've been working on a massive project that you guys are going to see next year, as well as some home renovations around the house. However, I just wanted to introduce you into this project and get you started. There are countless ways that you can do an input and output, as well as the pump placement. But if you guys want to see me do something more with this, let me know in the comment section below. Or feel free to take matters into your own hands and get creative with it. Personally, I would love to come back to this project and finish it off in the future, but I just don't have time this week. Again though, the main component of it is finished for $25. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next Sunday for a new do-it-yourself project.